Today we're going to show you how we transfer hundreds of our juvenile Australian Red Claw crayfish from a tank setup to an outside growout pond. The tank we'll be draining down is approximately 4 metres long by 1.4 metres wide. We initially stocked the tank with approximately 500 tiny craylings about 5 weeks ago. If everything has gone to plan and allowing for fatalities and cannibalism, we should have about 300 to 350 juveniles to collect. The first thing that we need to do is get everything ready before we begin draining the tank. We want to catch all the crayfish and get them moved to the outside pond as quickly as possible. You don't want to be wasting time searching for things that you need once you start. A large shallow bowl is required for keeping the young crayfish. Avoid using a deep bucket with a small surface area. The crayfish will end up on top of each other, potentially causing unnecessary casualties. Next, a large bowl is needed for placing aquatic plants, snails, pipes, and other items that you use for their hiding places. We have a lot of tree frogs here on the farm, so we also use a bucket to put any unwanted tadpoles in for removal. Before we open the tank's drain pipe, we place a fine mesh net underneath to catch any crayfish that manage to crawl out. A second net is placed close by to switch with the other net when it needs emptying. Now we can open the pipe and begin draining down the water in the tank. If the net is in direct sunlight, place something over the net to create shade. Crayfish are sensitive to strong light and easily become hot and stressed if left exposed. While the water level is dropping, you can begin removing the hiding places. Juvenile crayfish are experts in holding onto objects. Check everything that you remove to prevent potential escapees. Now it's the fun part where we begin collecting all the young crayfish. Although these crayfish were all introduced at the same time and the same age, their growth rates vary. After collection, you have two options what you want to do with them. Your first option is to grade each crayfish into different sizes and continue growing the smallest, then transfer the bigger crayfish into the grow-out pond. Your second option, which is what we do here on our farm, is transfer all the different sized crayfish straight into the grow-out pond. The reason we do this is because of our high rate of baby crayfish production. We continually require more tanks to hatch and grow our craylings, meaning available tank space is always at a premium. Ideally, it's best practice to stock similar-sized juvenile crayfish of around 1 to 2 inches into grow-out ponds to minimise predation. After all the hiding places have been removed, you can begin catching the remaining crayfish using a net or by hand. Remember to check aquatic plant root systems for any crayfish hiding. These are unwanted tadpoles that we relocate into our fish ponds as additional food for the fish. Once your tank is empty, use a hose or buckets of water to flush the remaining crayfish out of the drain pipe and into the net. Be careful not to scald the crayfish with hot water if your hose pipe has been exposed to direct sunlight. Let the water run through it until the temperature is cool. After you've captured all your crayfish, leave the hose pipe running, reintroduce the habitat, and close the drain pipe. The last full net will contain a certain amount of detritus, which makes grading your crayfish time consuming. To reduce this, rinse the net from above to remove the majority of the detritus before grading. This will make it a lot easier. On our farm, we simply empty the whole contents of the net into the outside pond, along with all the separated crayfish. Ensure the water temperature in the pond is not a lot higher than the water in the tank, or you'll risk killing all your crayfish. If the water in the pond is hotter than in the tank, agitate the water, which will cool it down. Now all the juvenile crayfish are safely stocked into your pond to continue growing bigger, finish refilling your tank. Then leave it for about 1 week before introducing your next batch of craylings. If you have any questions regarding growing crayfish at home, write a comment below and we'll get back to you. Or check out our other videos here.